Let's look at the Phoenix real estate market at a glance. A lot of things have happened since I did this 2 months ago. I do it every month or two, but let's look at it now. It's been a real popular series. I had over 1,000 views on one of my recent videos talking about the Phoenix real estate market. So let's look at this. This is the Phoenix real estate market at a glance. I put this out about every month. Sometimes I'll do a video on it, sometimes I won't. And I did one on August and September, and now let's update it for what's happening. One thing that I was concerned about back then was I felt like that the inventory was going to really increase very, very rapidly just from the data that I was looking at, and that really hadn't been talked about at the time, and I felt like I was a little bit out on a limb. But since I did that in August, it turns out that the kind of the general consensus has moved that direction. So the general consensus now is the next year is going to be kind of a normal year. Inventory is going to be much, much higher, and prices are going to be much, the increases in price are going to be much, much lower. So let's just look at what's happened since then. The biggest thing to change right here is this red line, which is the inventory. Last time I did this in August, it was, I just had August data, it was just starting to increase, or September data, it was just starting to increase, and it's gone up very rapidly since then. That's something you tend to see this time of year, because right now it's November 15th. In the fall, you tend to see it increase, but this is a real big increase. You can see what the increase was like last year, and this year it's super steep. And what we'll see in November, it'll go up again, and then it'll drop rapidly in January. There's a very common thing that a lot of people take their homes off the market around the holidays, and then it'll go up from there. So we're already above 20,000 on inventory, so we're getting close to the normal range. Now let's talk about the prices. Prices have been flat. This is the, you can see the number here for July. It's essentially, we haven't changed at all. And this is the median home price for all homes, including condos in the calculation. One thing that is also new this month was that the new homes, this purple line here is the new listings. And that's one of the, my big questions is why weren't the new listings increasing when prices had gone up so steeply? We finally see them break 10,000 new listings in a month. And that was last month in October. And I think that'll be a trend. Sales were down, were a little bit weaker, and the combination of a little bit weaker sales and a little bit higher new listings caused a very steep increase in inventory. And that's just the mathematics of it. The other factor in it is the number of homes that are taken off the market. Just as I'll digress here. This purple line is the new listings, and the blue line is the sales. And you can see that the gap between them two is what leads to inventory. Some of the homes that are in this gap are never going to be sold. They're going to be a lot of homes that are put on the market, never sell. But you can see this gap is what leads to this super strong increase in the red line, which is the inventory. And as it got really narrow here, it really tanked. The inventory really tanked when the gap got so tight. It's just a little bit more here. It's just slightly, and it's a little bit more again last month. But just small differences between new listings and sales can have a big impact on the number of home, the inventory of homes available that are listed for sale. So that gives you a pretty good idea of what's happening with the market. And one thing you'll notice here on the inventory, when the inventory was skyrocketing here in 2006, it didn't make prices go down, it made prices flatten out. It wasn't until we had 2 years of skyrocketing inventory and much lower sales, we had this huge gap essentially before prices fell. So what I think, if we start seeing really steep, we had really steep inventory here, if we continue seeing pretty steep inventory here, I don't think that'll bring prices down, but it would prevent prices from going up. So I was pretty certain prices would go up a little bit next year. Now I'm less certain of that. I think they probably will, but they could be flat. I don't think they're going to go down, because you can see what how difficult it is for prices to fall. It took 2 years of, look at this, skyrocketing inventory before prices moved down. And then when they did break, they broke like a dam. Okay, so that's so there's a possibility that prices won't go up much at all next year. So it could be a moderate increase, but if we'll see what happens to this inventory. That the inventory is getting close to normal levels. Okay, and now this is a new listings for all of Phoenix. This is only for the first 14 days in November, but it gives you an idea of what's happening in general for other months. And this is for, all sales, distressed sales plus normal sales for all of the areas served by the MLS. This is based on MLS data, but it's from the Cromford Report. Cromford Report is a great report. If you're a pro, you have to subscribe to it. So you can see that the blue here are normal listings, and the light blue and the light blue and the brownish orange and the gray, these are distressed sales. It's like short sales, bank owned, and HUD. And you can see there's a real strong trend towards the increase in the normal sales and a real sharp shrinkage in the distressed sales. Overall, the total number of homes that have hit the market, new listings, through the first 14 days of November is slightly below what it was last year. But the big change is it's changing towards normal sales and away from distressed sales. And the big change is that there's an increase in normal sales and a big change away from distressed sales. But it varies really, really a ton depending where you're looking at it. Like there was places like Gilbert was holy muscle. And you can see Gilbert is still increasing very rapidly on the regular sales. This is just single family. I'm sorry, this is just single family. So it's going up, and we should see next year that it'll be higher than in 2011, and maybe it'll be approaching these levels. But that's different. There's some others like Chandler right next door is very different. Let's look at Chandler. So Chandler's actually gone down. This is just for a partial for November, but kind of get the concepts of what's happening in general. That it's the number of new listings that are normal, the dark blue, are increasing, but not enough to offset the fall in distressed sales. It could be an anomaly since it's only half a month, but keep that in mind. And other areas are flat. One that's always intrigues me is Anthem. Anthem is one of the was a really cool zip code because it was one of the first where the prices stopped falling and were flat. And prices of Anthem have been pretty flat for years and years, well, since the big fall. And you can see why here. Their inventory has been generally flat, whether it's made up of a lot of distressed or very little distressed. And that's what's kept their prices from falling and keep their prices strong. Metro Phoenix, single family homes, and this is the trend of new listings, of normal new listings. So I think that'll continue. So anyway, I guess I should get back to the other one. Okay, let's get back to this. So the trend is flat or slightly increasing prices. The inventory is increasing extremely rapidly. I expect it to go up a lot next month in December. Will fall a lot in January, as typical as people take off the market for the holidays, and then we'll see what happens from there. But we're going to be definitely in a normal market range as far as inventory. If you're a home seller, let's talk about that. If you're a home seller, that means you're going to be frustrated. You have heard these stories about somebody, oh, I put it on, they got three offers in the first week. That's not going to happen anymore. That's over. We're back to a normal market. It's going to be a slugfest for you to get the home sold. So don't get cocky. Don't get your expectations and expect it to sell at like it did last year or the year before. Your prices are going to be higher than last year or the year before, but it's going to take longer to sell. So you could have sold a year ago and you would have made less money, but it was sold really quick. Or you could sell next year and make more money and take longer to sell. If you're a buyer, you're going to have a much better selection. So you'll be able to be more picky because there will be a lot more homes available for sale that meet your requirements. So great. If you're watching this on YouTube, please subscribe on YouTube. If you're on my website, Arizona Real Estate Notebook, that'd be great if you followed that. And I have a Google Plus account I'm trying to put a lot of data into. So you could follow me on Google Plus. It's just Google Plus and then plusjohnwake.com. And give me a call if you have any questions and want to shoot the breeze. I've been getting a lot of calls from people who want to decide whether to rent or sell. When their lease is coming up, they're trying to figure out what should I do. So give me a call. I can do a quick and dirty on what's the prices of the home is and give you some guidance on what you might do in a few months when your lease is up. Great. Take care.